Silk fibres can be turned into all types of artistic objects, like paper or fabric. The fibres are translucent, so they work very well with light shining through them, giving a warm, colourful glow that makes good mood lighting. They certainly make all things bright and beautiful. This lamp doesn't have shades. Instead, natural-looking silk flowers conceal lights, and the lamp base is made of branches. To create one, an artist begins with what's called a roving, a bundle of fibres harvested from a silk moth caterpillar's cocoon. The fibres have been cleaned and straightened. The roving is put into a nylon mesh bag, then submerged in dye that's formulated specially for colouring animal fibres such as wool and silk. The dye is heated to between 85 and 100 degrees Celsius. Then a bit more powdered dye is added to produce intermittent splashes of a bolder colour. After a couple of minutes, the roving is removed and the excess dye is rinsed off. The roving is hung on a rack and left there until it dries completely. Roving is typically spun into a thread to make silk fabric, but this artist puts a different spin on it. She spreads a sheet of tulle on her work table. Then, gently pulling outward with both hands, she separates the fine hair-like fibres, making piles, which she lays out on the tulle. Each pile will become a flower in the lamp. She folds over the tulle to create a barrier that prevents the fibres from sticking to her tools and her hands. She then saturates both sides of each pile with water that contains a few drops of washing up liquid. This opens up the fibres so that they'll easily absorb the polymer adhesive she'll apply next. But before that, she sponges off excess water and soaks up the remaining moisture with a towel so as not to dilute the adhesive. As the fibres absorb the adhesive, they fuse together, forming a sheet of silk fibre paper. After folding back the tulle, she begins moulding each paper into a flower. The moulding process is very simple. Each paper is spread over a balloon and left to dry overnight. The colourless roving has now been transformed into colourful sheets of mouldable silk fibre paper. The next day, she simply bursts the balloon and the silk fibre paper maintains the rounded shape. Using the adhesive once again, she now glues her silk fibre flowers to juniper branches. She secures them with needle and thread, matching the thread colour to the silk so that it blends in. She further sculpts the flowers with a stitch or two in select spots. She then dabs adhesive onto the thread to secure it. A second, slightly smaller flower is glued into each big flower to create two layers of petals. She then takes some fibres from a roving she's dyed green and glues them under the blooms to form wispy leaves. For the final touch, she places a small flower upside down over a battery-powered LED push light and positions it in the centre of each flower, turning this sculpture into a fully functioning lamp. The lamp doesn't need inner wiring, nor does it have to be plugged in. Pressing the middle of each flower turns its hidden push light on or off, providing a little light relief from a leaf. It's very good, is that petal? Mind you, I do think that these were made in the autumn.